Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Hunts Park Grizzly Field.
The battle between
the Grizzlies and the Mounties of Rogers. I'm Bo Sawyer, alongside my broadcast partner,
number one, Mason,
the Grizzly legend, Chad Frazier.
Coach, about all that. Thank you, though.
Coach, we need a win today.
Catcher, number 21.
We need a win today.
We need to win today, no doubt. It's been a slow start, and these guys have really worked hard on trying to. They've had some. Had some close ball games that they've had an opportunity to win. Low scoring ball games and hadn't got it going offensively quite yet. But hopefully, the second half, you're going to get in the second half of the conference season right now, the back half of it. Hopefully, they can get it going a little bit.
Coach Little standing beside you. He's got the wireless on today. It's good to have him.
That's a legend right there.
Yeah, that is a legend. Yeah, take a little time out to come in and help us out on the broadcast, Coach. We appreciate you.
Well, it's good to be here. It's a beautiful day for a ball game.
I guess of these outdoor sports, you get a day that's as windy as this. You want to take advantage of it when you can, fight it when you have to. Matlock. We're introducing our Grizzlies right now. We lost 8-1 against these guys last night in Rogers. I think it was a close game up until had a couple of bad breaks. And that's the way it's been all year, Coach. You were talking about that earlier.
Yeah, it has. That's kind of been the trend. Is you know.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask that you please rise.
Yeah, we're gonna go call the mic for our national anthem.
Direct your attention towards our nation's colors for the singing of our national anthem. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed? At the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the buff bursting in.
But, yeah, we were talking about how the first half of the conference season's gone for them, but that's kind of been the trend is, you know, we've been pitching it pretty well, playing some pretty good defense, but when you're not scoring a lot of runs, puts a lot of pressure on you defensively, and that's kind of been the deal is we have one or two bad innings defensively and teams have been separating from us, and hopefully we can change that offensively and keep, you know, find a way to get better and play solid and keep getting good outings on the mound.
Yeah, that's exactly right. You played a good team tonight. I mean, Rogers is 6-1 in the conference, just behind Rogers Heritage. The Heritage, you know, they've got a really good baseball team this year, and it's you got to like that for them because they have struggled with so many other sports for so long.
Yeah.
But playing Rogers tonight, boy, if we could get a win tonight, it'd go a long way in what we need to do to try to get into the tournament. Once we get past Rogers, we've got Southside, Bentonville, and Springdale, I believe, of the lower half.
Yeah, you've got some winnable ball games as long as you continue to get better and you clean up, you know, the parts of the game that you can control, playing well defensively and getting good outings on the mound and just trying to find a way to scratch out and produce runs, which is what's been the struggle so far. But when you look at the teams at the top of the conference right now, like you said, Rogers Heritage, Rogers High, Fayetteville, har-ber, Bentonville West, and Bentonville, those teams, you know, in recent years have been the cream of the crop and been fighting it out in the top half to get to the state tournament and compete for conference championships, and it's no different this year.
Chief, we've Taylor's going to pitch.
Andrew Taylor will open up for us. We got Alex Martinez, catcher. Max Howard to be at first. Mason Kincannon,
get in the action
second. Maddox will be at short. Lucas Caldera, third. Jackson Stevens, left field. Logan Matlock will be in center. And Elijah Fieri will be in right field. A little high and outside to get this started. At some point today, we're going to try to talk to McLean Moody. Coach, I know you've had a lot of contact with him, kind of know what's going on. He's had an injury, and I think he's going
to
be clear.
2 to 3 weeks left of the season right there, technically. And, it, you know, he's going to need every bit of that to even have a chance if we can find a way to get in the state tournament. So, you know, we'll see how that goes. But I don't think, you know, Coach Hankins and the staff are, you know, they're really going to pressure him to try to get back for the state tournament. It's a big ask right now. And, you know, we'll see how it goes. But he's trying to get through it. He's still pain-free the last 3 or 4 weeks. So, you know, hopefully it'll stay that way.
Yeah, and you sure would like to have him in the lineup. He's such a difference maker, not just in football, but baseball too.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. You know, he's one of our better hitters. We're sitting here talking about some things that you know, we're struggling offensively a little bit. He is one of our better hitters as well, and we don't have him in the lineup. So, you know, obviously that hurts a little bit.
Yeah, that was Caleb Champion. First at bat, got a walk. He's at first. And he'll try to get to second. Throws a little bit high. He'll be safe.
Got a good jump on him right there. Rogers is going to do that. You know, Matt Melson's the head coach at Rogers. Been there a long time. Rogers guy. Went to high school there. Good friend of mine. He and I played college baseball together at West Ark back in the day. And, man, he's a, you know, does a great job. I mean, he's, you know, one of the best coaches in the state of Arkansas, if not the best. And does a great job with him.
Try to get to third. Yeah. He slid under the tag, safe.
Gonna have to get a slide step going. Andrew is to give Alex a chance to throw him out. He's picking his leg up and giving him some time, and he's got to give him a chance to throw him out. So hopefully they'll make that adjustment.
This is the second baseman, Jacob Watson, at the plate. 1-1 is the count to him. Still a little high, 2-1.
Talking to Coach Melson, Jason Watson, he really does a good job handling the bat. Smart baseball player. Good hands on the infield. He's a senior leader for him, so they expect big things out of the line right here.
Well, we welcome in all of our Grizzly Sports Network fans as always, and we'd also like to welcome in all the Rogers Mounties fans. I'm pretty sure that they were notified yesterday that we'd be broadcasting this game, and we're glad to be back here at Hunts Park. What a beautiful place this is.
Absolutely. Great place to play a baseball game, especially when the sun's out and there's not a cloud in the sky.
Boy, this time of year, you have no idea what you're going to get. We were watching the flags earlier. Just kind of get an idea which way the wind's going. And it's going from center to right. Earlier, it's been swirling around since the game started. We've got one of our cameras in the crow's nest in center field. And told him, whatever you do, protect that camera.
Yeah. We had football practice this afternoon before I came over here. And the wind was just absolutely it'll blow you over at times today. It is pushing hard.
Three and two is the count. Got a runner at third. That's Caleb Champion. Stole second, then stole third.
Coach Melson really bragged about him. And first thing came out of his mouth when he talked to me about the Champion kid, he said he runs really well. He stole two bags right out of the gates.
Yeah, came off the bag. You've got Lucas Caldera, third. Good job for Lucas.
Yeah, just pulled him off.
Pulled the bag a little bit.
Pulled Max off the bag. But the Champion, he signed with Southeast Missouri State, who's a really good Division I baseball program. So,
yeah, well, I've just looked to your left and I thought I was going to see Coach Little, but instead I see Ashton, and she's got a headset on. Sure is a lot better looking than her dad.
You see the boss of the little household. That's who that is right there.
She got all her looks from her mother. Runners at the corners. Zach Lloyd at the plate. Zach's the shortstop for the Mounties.
I would expect them to continue to be aggressive right here. See if they can steal another bag and get runners on second, third with nobody out.
We just need some good things to happen for the Grizzlies. They just fought so many bad breaks so far this year. Mm-hmm. It's time starts turning around a little bit. There's another chopper. That will be foul.
Lawing's a junior. He's their shortstop. Probably their best hitter, according to Coach Melson, overall. Really got a lot of pop at the plate.
When's football practice actually start?
I think we're going to start May 4th, I believe.
Well, he took a shot to the leg there. He'll go to first. Now the bases are loaded. Reese Barriola, four-hole hitter. So Martinez will lead his team to the mound and wait for Coach Hankins to get there, and we'll try to talk this one out.
Big jam early to be in. Bases loaded, nobody out, top of the first. You really got to work to get out of this one. You get out with one or two runs and that's it. That's probably a win. They'll take it.
You know, guys, I don't know if you discussed it, but the pitcher, Andrew, he got hit before the game started in warm-ups. So got hit pretty good in the back. So I don't know how that's affecting his pitching or not.
Yeah, you wonder if he's tightening up a little bit from that or what. But, yeah, he got smoked. Rogers was taking infield, and we were over there huddled up, and one of their kids overthrew the first baseman and hit him right in the back.
He did something to his hand earlier, too, before they even took any infield.
Good pitch right there. That's what he needs to do. He just needs to get in a groove right here, get in a rhythm, throw some pitches that we can make some plays on. See if we can't get one out at a time and get out of this.
Good job by Martinez.
Yeah, he's really done a good job this year blocking it up and defending behind the plate. He's thrown out a lot of base runners and kept us in ball games, being able to defend and catch and throw. So certainly could get crazy today on a ball in the air, on pop-ups, pop fly, balls on the infield, fly balls in the outfield. You got to do a good job of communicating, not give up on baseballs. Good pitch.
Cheers.
Good pitch.
Just one at a time.
That's it. There's one. Now you're a ground ball away from getting out of it. Roll it up right here and get out of it.
Hey, number three, Aiden Linson.
Good pitch.
Vincent, their catcher.
Good curveball right there.
At the plate. Just one down. Base is still loaded.
Idea. You can swing at it once, come right back with it again. Corners are in right here, playing with your toes on the grass. Typically in this situation, you're gonna go home on the corners and roll it up the middle. So we keep the ball in the infield. Let's see if we can get out of this. Good pitch. Yeah,
nice pitch.
Curveball's working now. He's got some hard late action on it. He can settle in and locate that fastball. We'll be in for a battle.
Taylor settled down a little bit. Trying to get the feel. Here comes the 1-2.
Nothing like getting smoked with a baseball about 85 miles an hour across the infield right before you walk out to pitch, right between the shoulder blades.
So Coach Frazier, a lot of people do not know the difference. What is the difference in the action between a slider and a curveball?
Typically, your curveball is going to be, if you're looking at a clock, more of a 12-6 action. And it depends on the pitcher's arm slot. So you're going to get more of a downward breaking action on it. Slider, you're going to get more of a diagonal action, down and away more action on it. And, the tough thing about a slider is it's a lot tougher to pick up the spin typically on a slider than it is a curveball if you know what you're looking for. And, a lot of times with the curveball, guys that are good hitters, they can see the fingers in front of the breaking ball, in front of the baseball as they're releasing it. Slider's a little tougher to pick up because you're getting around the ball just a little bit more, and it looks like a fastball coming out, and it's hard to pick it up because you don't see the laces, you don't see the spin on it as
big
much.
Pitch here, 3-2, right back.
There it is, double play. Got out of it. There we go.
That's what you have. Great job by the Grizzlies to get out of that one.
Good play by Maddox right there.
All right, we're going to take a break. This game is being brought to you by Fort Smith Therapy. Stay with us. We'll be back with more Grizzly baseball action right after this.
Between life, work, and family, sometimes the person that you need to take care of the most is you.
At Fort Smith Therapy Health and Wellness, you're never alone. Through our counseling, we can help you regain control of your emotions, mental health, and life. We provide both face-to-face and virtual therapy services. Whether it's for your child, family, or yourself, Fort Smith Therapy is here to help your true self shine through.
Schedule your appointment today with Fort Smith Therapy Health and Wellness.
Forget about X's and O's. The only play you're running is chicken. So what combo are you picking? We've got tailgates of hand-battered, cooked-to-order chicken fingers and cane sauce. Touchdown! And jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. This season is about to be unbeatable. Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers. One love.
All right, welcome back to Hunts Park. The bases were loaded, no outs. Grizzlies able to work their way out of that one. Patient, that's what you got to be in a situation like that. Don't panic.
Yeah, Andrew, he's got a lot of baseball under his belt, and he's been in those situations. So, being able to kind of maintain your composure and get in there and make a couple quality pitches, get out of it, and the guys play behind him, so –
in the bottom of the first inning.
Yeah, that was a good way to get out of it.
Andrew will be first up for the Grizzlies.
Good swing. Good balanced swing right there.
This guy's got that typical left-handed trailing fastball.
Yeah, he does.
It's tough.
Yeah, Ty Anderson is the pitcher for the Mounties.
Strike thrower, according to Coach Melson. 3-year starter for him. Logged a lot of innings. Flipped the baseball to him a bunch to go win some ball games, and he's been a part of a lot of big wins, I'm sure, with the success that they've had in recent years. So, got a veteran guy on the mound.
So, you talk about the pitchers in high school. You really like to have strike throwers and guys that are really not trying to get the most out of every pitch. And when you see a guy like this have the success he does, you know, sometimes just a good hard, good pitch right down the gut's hard to hit.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it. I mean, you know, thank you. I think the best thing, you know, people, a lot of people don't understand, you talk about pitching and you got eight other guys around you that you want to play, you know.
That was hit hard right back to Jacob Watson. Watson makes the play for the Mounties. One down for the Grizzlies. Now Mason Kincannon at the plate.
It takes a lot of pressure off of you as a pitcher when you got guys around you that are going to make routine plays.
Yeah.
And that's all you're asking them to do. You're not asking them to make great plays ever. You know, that those will come, but you're just asking them to make routine plays.
You know, the great plays come in no-hitters, situations like that.
They do. Yeah,
that's what it takes to get to that level.
Tight ball games, you know, you get in tight ball games every now and then. You got to have a great play. Somebody step up and make one. But hey, those guys take ground balls and fly balls and practice every day, and they want to be involved. At the end of the day, there's an old saying: as long as that hitter is turning right after the play's over. You're
that's
in good
exactly
shape.
Right.
You know, you're in good shape.
I want to see the roundy rounds.
That's right.
1-2. Strikes him out.
A lot of run on that fastball.
Alex Martinez.
These defensive guys, you know, whoever's on the field, if you're playing defense, you want ground balls and fly balls. And there's an old saying that, you know, ground balls and fly balls are more democratic. Everybody keeps everybody happy, you know. Strikeouts are fascist. Nobody gets to play except for the pitcher and the catcher.
that's like hitting fairways.
That's right.
Takes all the fun out
that's
of
right.
it.
That's right. That's exactly right.
And, you know, teams love – defensively, they love pitchers that pound the zone.
Absolutely.
If they're going to have an active game, it's going to be a quicker game.
Yep. That's right. That's what I was telling. I didn't know if you heard me say it, but ground balls, got defensive guys like ground balls, they're more democratic. Good pitch.
Struck him out.
Good pitch.
Three up, three down.
Well, Alex probably thinking that ball was going to be up a little bit.
No runs. No
hits. 0-0 after one. Stay with us. We'll be back with more Grizzly baseball after this.
REP is your trusted source when it's time for you to sell your business or if you are looking to acquire one. We offer a variety of services that help prepare your business for sale. And we also counsel and advise you every step of the way. We take pride in our experience, market knowledge, and integrity. You can be assured your business is in the right hands. Resolution Equity Partners, partnering with you now, preparing for the future.
Consumer Notice. Interest rates are at a 22-year high. To gauge the demand for lower rates, or Chevrolet of Fort Smith is holding a great percent event. 1.9% financing for 60 months on select models is in effect. New 2023 Silverado 1500. New 2023 Equinox. New 2023 Trailblazers. 1.9% financing. Plus, get over $3,000 in or extra value. Or Chevrolet of Fort Smith.
Yes, sir.
All right. All right, welcome back. 0-0. We've got Coach Amy Walden here with the headset on, Lady Bears softball head coach. Coach, how's everything going?
Oh, doing all right, man. Mid-season grind, for sure.
It is a grind. Boy, we need to get us a win tonight here. Just so many things. I was talking to Coach Fraser before the game. Getting a lot of bad breaks so far this year. It just needs some good things to happen. You know, we got a good team. We've got good fielders. We've got good hitters. Just need some good things to happen.
Absolutely.
Andrew seems like he's getting a little bit of a groove right here, starting to loosen up a little bit after getting smoke between the shoulder blades before the game with a baseball.
That and being down so, you know, with bases loaded, no outs to start with, and then be able to work your way out of it.
Yeah.
You've got to feel a lot better.
Yeah, he was able to grind his way out of it, and they made a couple plays for him. It's
Bryson McIntosh, left fielder at the plate for the Mounties. What about he's 6-1? Is that what they are?
Yes, 7-1.
7-1. We lost to him last night.
6-1.
So if we can get a win tonight, that's huge. Then we have Southside back to back Monday and Tuesday. Need to get a couple of wins there. You know, work our way back, trying to get tournament ready. You know, it's definitely attainable. You know, we're getting into that half of the season where playing some of the – once we get past Rogers, you know, some of the teams that are a little lower in the standings.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, typically – and I don't – Coach Walden, you can help me out on this, but no baseball-wise, typically, you know, you get to 4, maybe 5 wins. You can usually be in that 6th spot. 4 might get you in. You'll probably be in a tie with somebody if you get 4 wins. 5, most of the time, will get you in to that 6th spot. Is that kind of the way it works in softball for y'all, too?
Absolutely. Yeah, you've got usually in our conference, as far as your top 5 are usually pretty solid, and that 6 is usually where people are kind of fighting for. Yeah. But usually about 4 wins. It's a good place to be to at least get in.
Now, when's our next game?
So we play tomorrow at home.
At home?
Yes.
Okay.
Against Rogers. And then we'll play in non-conference on Friday at Lamar.
How's Rogers in softball?
They're pretty salty.
Good.
They're one of the top teams in our conference for sure. They've got most of their girls back. They've got about 4 girls that can take the circle and can throw it up there. So.
You know, I love our facilities. I'm in Rogers a lot. We do a lot of business up in Northwest Arkansas, and seeing the facilities at Heritage, their softball and baseball looks pretty impressive from the road. I haven't been inside the facility yet, but are they as nice?
Yes. So Rogers and Rogers Heritage both have kind of what we joke around is the mini Bogle. You know, I mean, but they both are almost identical complexes, and they're beautiful, fully turfed.
Yeah.
Just got it all going on.
And I like their football field at Heritage, too. It's one of my favorite places to broadcast from. It's a cool field. You know, they just haven't been very good for a pretty good while now. So it's always fun to broadcast there because you usually get a win, too.
Yeah, their spring sports up there in Northwest Arkansas, they've really gone the extra mile and put a lot of money into them, much like we have right here in Fort Smith with talking baseball-wise and softball-wise out at Martin Luther King Park where our girls play. And Got some nice facilities around here, too.
Oh, no doubt. We get lots of compliments on our – I mean, I know we're natural, but mm-hmm. we get a lot of compliments yeah. on our natural surface, for sure.
Which is a lot of work to maintain. It is. You got to mow it. You got to drag it. You got to replace dirt. And, you know.
It is a lot of work.
It is a lot of work. It's a labor of love, for sure. You know.
Jake Taylor, the right fielder for the Mounties at the plate. No outs.
I would say in my years of dragging fields, I got pretty good at it.
Shot to
we'll
center.
Give you a credit for that.
Matlock's going to size this one up. We'll score run.
Sack fly, but we got an out of it. If we can keep it to one or two right here, this will be a good inning. So, good pitch by Andrew right there. Give himself a chance to get that first out. So, Coach Walden, talk about some of your girls. Who's playing well for you right now? Who's pitching it well? Who's swinging it?
Man, I'll tell you. So, Eden Davis right now is our leading hitter. She's got the highest batting average as far as over the course of the season. But I've got several that, man, they're playing very consistent. Mallory Craig, senior, great leader.
Yeah.
She's a great ball player all the way around, works her tail off. And then Jayla's right behind her, you know, as far as working her tail off and leading. And then I've got a couple of young ones as well. That I got a couple of freshmen that are starting to kind of show a little bit.
Great throw. Great play right what there. Alex play. Mason. Man,
it was
great
job
by nice. Mason hanging in there, wasn't it?
Yeah, nice throw. It looked like it was going to get away from him. But a great job by Mason just making the catch.
Those plays right there. Turn out big.
They
you
do.
Know, Coach Walden, those very girls – talked about are the ones that I would have expected you to talk about. They're, you know, they're great teammates, great leaders, and
absolutely.
You know, they want to win.
Their parents want to talk a lot about senior night, and I'm not ready for that yet. So
the Bears get out of there with
one run.
One
That's
run.
A good inning right there. Started off in a jam.
We'll take a break. Stay with us. More Grizzly baseball after
one
this.
Run, run, run.
At Hug Chevrolet Buick GMC, we dial 782-8940.
This is Joe Calderera with Taliano's Restaurant. We call 782-8940.
Keep warm this winter with a York high-efficiency furnace. Or for more information on endless hot water and a high-efficiency tankless water heater, give Blaylock Heat and Air and Plumbing Services a call at 782-8940.
That's 782-8940.
Family. It's bigger than bloodlines, stronger than DNA. It's the circle we draw around the people that matter, the people we care about and care for, the folks who inspire us, guide us, root for us. Family means finding common ground, rolling up our sleeves, and making our way side by side. Armstrong Bank. Strength runs in our family.
With an older car, there's so much maintenance. Knowing that my brakes are covered for life with the Golden Guarantee is a relief. I'd like to be driving this car forever, so that's why I keep taking it back to Midas.
At Escape Camper Vans, we exist to make the outdoors more accessible.
We have about 630 vans in our fleet. These vehicles get so much wear and tear. Knowing that there's a warranty on parts through Midas, the Golden Guarantee is so important to our business.
And Howerton at the plate for the Grizzlies. In the bottom of the second, down 1-0. Earlier, you heard Coach Little talking to Coach Walden. And Coach Little was the head coach for the Lady Bears, and he handed the baton off to Coach Walden. And you guys, a lot of the players that are still playing now, I think your seniors, Coach, you know a lot about them as younger players. And Mallory, I was really impressed with her last year. Didn't have a lot of velocity, but just had a lot of stuff.
Right, yeah. She, she has worked so hard to get to where she's at.
Yeah.
And she can spot that ball anywhere you want it to go. She's going to work to get it there and has done a really good job.
That was a great play by Zach Lloyd, shortstop. for the Mounties to snag that one and throw Howerton out. He got a good lick on it.
Yeah, I mean, that's all you can do is hit it hard. He hit it right at him. They had him played position-wise. They had him played pretty good.
Elijah Crary.
Made a good play on it.
Yeah, talk about Mallory. She threw a changeup last year. It almost made me gasp when she did it. I mean, I leaned out of the press box.
She's got a good change. She's got a good drop. Like I said, her locations are wonderful. And even teams that are going to hit her, when she spots it, they struggle. So,
Coach Little was there. He had Kaylin Massey was a pitcher for. Kaylin, is she still in Texas?
She is.
How's she doing?
Doing well. I think she just got.
Yeah, she just got conference player of the week last week. Yeah.
Awesome.
She's a great kid.
I turned on the TV last year. Turned on the TV on ESPN, and she was pitching against LSU.
Yeah, sure was. So,
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Prairie View made it to the Women's College World. Well, they didn't make it to the World Series, but regionals. Uh-huh. They opened up with OU. The number one team in the nation.
Yeah.
And they struggled, but just to be able to experience that must have been pretty neat.
She came great back experience. And saw us last summer and talked a little bit about that as well.
So. She's a great kid.
Yes.
I was talking to Coach Hankins yesterday. He said that he was talking about Caden Washington, and I think they played Auburn this year. And he said, well, you got shelled, you know, but it was great experience for him.
Yeah.
Straight up.
Caden's had a few good outings, and he's had a few outings where, he struggled a little bit. Yep. But, I mean, he's just, he's hanging in there and trying to make the most out of his career, and he's at a good place.
Number 17, Evan Ross.
He's at a good place at Austin Peay, and Coach Fanning down there. They do a great job. He's a young head coach and does a great job recruiting. And he's taking pretty good care of Caden, I think.
So. Evan Ross, the DH at the plate. Defensively, we've done well. Get out of the jams we've been in, but we've got to start getting some base runners.
Yeah, got to get some base runners, try to put some pressure on them a little bit. Obviously, they got the opportunity to make great plays. I just made one a minute ago to get the first out of the inning. But.
Kind of a common thing for us as well.
Get down, ball.
Well, I caught the gap between left and center. Bobbled a little bit, and he'll definitely slide into second. You just got to ask for a base hit. That's all you got to do. You just got to ask for it.
Just got to beg a little bit.
Jackson Stevens.
Just goes to show you continuously put balls in play. Even good teams are going to mess up and make mistakes. And just like right there, that really should have been a single. That's a single with a one base error, but they kicked it around in the outfield and gave us an extra bag, and we'll take it.
Get a two-out rally here.
Tell mine constantly, put the ball in play, good things happen.
Right.
String together some, put a couple of runs on the board.
It's always good when you make the other team throw it and catch it. That was really close.
He called him safe.
I think he was safe.
Yeah.
Really close to balking.
Man, that was close. Lloyd thought he had him. He was headed to the dugout. It was called safe. Nice rip.
Coach Little?
Stevens would be nice.
Was that the Nature Boy Ric Flair I just heard on the loop?
You heard that. Boy, I just saw that swing. It's hard. He was pull swing right there. It's hard to hit a pull, hard to pull a trailing fastball from a lefty.
Well, he's taking a cut at it.
two strikes now. He needs to spread out, shorten up a little bit. Looks like that's what he's trying to do. And try to drive it right back at him. And see what happens.
Three big swings. But that was a majestic out.
No, right. Majestic. Runner left.
1-0 after two. We'll take another break. Stay with us. We'll be back with more Grizzly baseball after this.
Whether it's record temperatures or below freezing, Ted's is here to keep you comfortable all year long. We've been in business for over 55 years, and we love serving our community. Call today and schedule your seasonal checkup so you're always prepared for what's around the corner. Ted's Air Conditioning and Heating, always ready to help. Tell us you saw Duke and save 10%.
Sawyer's is about more than sunrooms, patios, and home improvement. For over 30 years, we've been about people, about our community, about you. We make quality products affordable so you can focus on making memories with those who matter most. We bring our passion for great craftsmanship and take pride in the work we do so you can count on it lasting a lifetime. Give us a call today and see the difference we can make for you.
One to zero after two innings. Caitlin Champion, leadoff hitter for the Mounties, will be up.
I think we got Andrew in a little bit of a groove now.
Number two, Caitlin Champion.
A little slow start in the first inning and then starts piecing it together. He's throwing the ball well so far.
Champion, who stole two bases last time up, center fielder, takes it low, 1-0.
Definitely a table setter for Rogers right here, the champion kid. He's typical leadoff guy.
So your leadoff guys, do they normally lead in stolen bases? Do you see that a lot,
I think typically you would like them to. You know, I mean, get a guy or a girl at the top of the order that can really run and create a lot of trouble defensively for you, for the pitcher and the catcher. But typically, I'm going to say yes, you know. Yeah.
So when you're looking for a leadoff hitter in your lineup, you're looking for a guy that's got some speed, guy that can make contact, not necessarily a real power hitter, just somebody that can get it going. Okay, we got
there
you.
There we go.
There we go.
No, I look for somebody that's going to do whatever it takes to get on base. But, yes, with speed, that's right. Also going to be very smart in how they approach.
Well, Champion gets the first. He walked his first time at bat. But, obviously, he's a dangerous runner. You saw what he did the first time. I'm sure Andrew Taylor is aware of that.
I'd like to pull out some statistics to tell you when my leadoff gets on, we do better offensively, but I don't have any hard statistics in front of me.
No doubt.
Always makes a coach feel a little better.
Absolutely.
You get a leadoff person, leadoff guy that is, you know, low strikeout, high contact, can run. They increase their odds of getting on base in a hurry.
Absolutely.
This is the second baseman, Jacob Watson.
I like one, too, that can get a quality at bats, can give you a lot of different looks from the pitcher, and give everybody else a chance to see what's coming.
Yeah, and I think it's important for all hitters to be able to not be afraid to hit with two strikes.
Absolutely.
You know, just for that reason that you're talking about is, you know, being able to hit with two strikes, you get to see a variety of pitches in your, if you're willing to sit up there and take a couple pitches. And
well, Ken Cannon just does a great job. Concentration to make the play
you know, both of them, both Ken Cannons. You got one at second, one at short. But to be able to concentrate when your runner's sliding and be able to make that catch and still try to do something with it.
Yeah, he's doing a good
pretty
job.
Pretty special.
He's doing a good job of picking that thing out of the dirt. And, he's getting there just a hair late, but he's doing a great job. You know, Alex has thrown him. He's short-hopped him twice on target, you know, accurate throws, but short-hopped him twice. He's done a good job of digging them out, keeping them on the infield, and actually catching them clean, which is impressive. Yeah.
You know, actually having a turf field, using that turf as a bouncing spot is probably pretty good. But short hops are tough. You know, I always told my catchers, no hop, one hop, but no short hop.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's
– yeah.
You know, you can tell that the catcher is using the turf for that purpose, but so he's just getting a little too far.
That was going to be my next question. What is the difference? How does the ball react different on turf than it does grass or dirt?
It doesn't bounce up. You know,
okay, so it stays flat.
It stays on a lower trajectory, you know, when you throw it like that.
Skips.
Now, if it's a high hopper, yeah, it's going to bounce, but it skips better than on grass.
Get a little truer hop, but a faster pace game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was talking to Jay Richardson last year, and he was saying that the first time that he played on turf, man, it was like an eye-opener.
Yeah, back in those days when we were playing, Jay's a couple years older than me, but the old school AstroTurf that we used to play on that would just take chunks out of your body. Yeah.
Yeah, that was AstroTurf on concrete.
That's exactly right. And it literally was. And but yeah, that played really, really fast. These, you know, this new age turf that we have now.
It's a different ball game.
Yeah, with the rubber that's in it and all, it softens it up a little bit. And
You played some football games.
These kids don't know how good they got it with this stuff.
But you played some football games at War Memorial, didn't you?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, did you come out bloody?
No, I didn't because I didn't play. I was backing up Chris Carter.
I go. And he's here, by the way. We'll see if he got bloody.
Yeah, yeah.
How in the world could you back up that guy?
You know, I mean.
Couldn't you have sat him down?
Sometimes I just had to question the coaches, you know. No.
There again, he short hopped that one.
Yeah.
The champion makes his way to second or third.
I say that
Watson
joking.
Watson to second.
Chris Carter was an outstanding quarterback. He got us to the state championship game his senior year. And I need to say this so he doesn't hear it, so his head doesn't get.
He's
hit.
Not looking. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. He was a really good quarterback for Northside High School. Did a great job.
He had some good genetics.
Yeah, he did.
That was Lloyd. That was hit by a pitch the last time at bat. Hit by a pitch then. So this is kind of a replay.
Yeah.
First
kinda,
inning.
Kind of.
Bases
kinda
are loaded.
Got himself in a jam here. Seen him get out of it one time. He can do it again. Quality pitches.
This is Barriola, their four-place hitter. He struck out the last time. So we need to keep that going. Fouled that one back.
Headache.
Ooh. Yeah. No,
that was right on top of that, too.
Where we're seated, there is a gap when it comes over the net before it gets to the cover of the bleachers. And I will watch it all the way to contact. That give you a headache.
Got to watch for the ricochets, too.
No doubt.
Yeah. Oh, well hit. Center field, and that will bounce over the wall.
That ball was well struck.
Yeah, that was well struck. What Elijah had to get on his horse to try to chase that one. That's the deepest part of the field there. But you got a lot of help with the wind, too. That is exactly where it's blowing, but he got a good bat on that one. Nice lick.
I've, in all my years playing and coaching here, I've seen I can probably count on one hand how many balls I've seen hit out of the park in that exact spot, right at that deep corner. It is an absolute graveyard. You cannot.
Wasn't Lenny one of the few?
Barry was one of them. Yeah, he hit one out there that hit in the middle of Greenwood Road. And
was there wind like this, or was it
no,
a cold day?
No, it was a normal day. It was a normal day, but he absolutely hammered one out there. It's a poke to get it out there. Yeah. It doesn't carry well out there.
Right. You know. Yeah, that wind can help you or hurt you on days
like
this.
Oh, yeah, no
sure.
doubt. And I've seen one in all my years, right-handed hitter, hit it out down the right field line right over the 330 sign. It's a poke for a righty to get it out that way going opposite field. Just can't help but wonder if, you know, Andrew isn't tightening up a little bit from getting hit by that baseball. And he'll be the last one to make an excuse. I'm going to make it for him, but you got to think that might be affecting him a little bit. Kind of chilly today.
Uh-huh.
You just don't know if that might be tightening up on him.
And he did something to his hand. I don't know if he did it in the dugout.
Okay.
Before they went out for infield, but so he did something to his throwing hand and then also got hit in the back. So yeah, he's
a tough kid. So that's
now,
you know,
number 11, Zach Lovett. Brick.
That's Logan. Check that. That's Logan Parnell.
Parnell.
That's going to be pitching
Landon
for
Parnell.
Grizzlies now.
Yeah, Landon Parnell.
Landon, yeah.
Talking about the mental aspect of the game right there when you're talking about that. I mean, I know when I've been hit, even throwing BP, I'm a little gun shy when the ball comes back at me.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, that's happened a few times. You hadn't coached long enough if you haven't been abused by a softball or a baseball throwing bat in practice.
No doubt. I took one to the shin in November, and I can still feel it. So,
so quick story. This is funny. I'm telling myself. So when I was the head baseball coach here a long, long time ago, I had a young man by the name of Ian Gilley who was a real prospect. I mean, he was a really talented kid. Best right-handed hitter I've ever coached. And so I had a scout for the Orioles call me who wanted to come see him swing it in practice. We had a JV game that day, so I stayed back with the varsity kids. Assistant coaches took the JV kids. And he's sitting right up here in the bleachers, the scout for the Orioles. And I'm out there on the field throwing bat in practice. And when I threw it, I followed through and I kind of hung my foot out behind the L-screen. Out from behind the L screen, so it was exposed. And Ian hit a line drive right back at me, and it hit me in the square in the top of my foot. And when it hit my foot, it fell straight down. It didn't ricochet anywhere. I mean, it just completely, my foot completely absorbed it. And it broke my foot.
Oh, my God.
In three places. And that guy came running down. The other kids came running. And, hey, but I didn't go down.
That's all that matters.
I did not go down. And the kids all come running out there, and he comes running down. He's, Coach, you are. I said, yeah, I'll be all right, but I couldn't walk.
When you break your coach's foot in three places, that ought to get you an offer.
Yeah. And, well, he wound up getting drafted by the Braves that year. So
Ian Gilley.
Out of high school. Yeah, he was drafted in the 42nd round. It was back when they had 50 rounds, and now they've just got 20, I believe. But, yeah, he wound up getting drafted out of high school, and he was a really talented kid. Good pitch. Good job, Caldera.
Nice job from Lucas Caldera. That's what you want a pitcher to do, just come in, like we talked earlier, throw strikes.
That's it.
They keep swinging. That was Aiden Linson, the catcher.
Now that hit number 18, Andrew Blankenship.
One pitch at a time. That's what you got to think right here.
Blankenship is their DH.
Good pitch.
Good pitch.
I think if he throws that same curveball again, he can get the strike two and then really. There it is.
Yeah.
Oh,
I thought that caught the edge.
I thought that was a strike, Coach Little.
Pitchers always begging for strikes.
Yeah, you're right. No doubt about it.
Well, Coach Walden, didn't you were supposed to play Southside earlier this year and it got postponed. So when is your makeup date?
Yes, sir.
For that?
So we are scheduled for April the 8th. Oh. Fun day.
Oh, that is out of here. Well, it looked like it wasn't going to go foul. It just kept carrying, and the wind's blowing left to right, held it up a little bit.
Yeah, it did.
He hit it out right over the 315 foul pole. That
really
is their
swing.
DH. Yeah.
Really good swing.
Yes, so we are scheduled to make up that Southside game on April 8th, and then we'll turn right around and play them April the 9th at our place.
How about in number six, Hudson Hennigan.
In the eighth, the day of the eclipse?
It is. It's going to be quite the adventure.
Right. Do I have to play in the eclipse classes or what?
We might. You never know, man.
That
never know.
That's Monday? Monday.
Monday's the
8th. So April 8th, we're going to play at Southside. It'll be our pink night. And then April the 9th, we'll be at Grizzly Field for Military Appreciation Night.
It's going to be cloudy on Monday. They're going to move that eclipse to Tuesday.
They might. You don't know. It's crazy.
So you're playing Southside on back-to-back days?
Yes, sir. That was not our intention, but that's how it had to work out this year.
That's on the schedule you sent me today?
I sent you the home schedule.
Okay.
But I'll send you the updated full schedule as well if you would like it. We'll be playing. Baseball will be playing, I think, Southside those days as well. So we got a lot going on.
Hudson Hennigan, third baseman for the Mounties.
Good pitch.
Takes a strike.
Live a long time at that location right
yes,
there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and this guy's back foot is halfway across the line, so he is hugging the plate.
Good pitch. Way to throw him inside.
Location, location, location.
Standing on the plate. Now, you know, if you weren't in a full count right now, be a good time to maybe throw a little brush back right here. Not many of these kids pitch like that anymore, Coach Little. Good spot. He's standing on the plate. That ball's 2 inches off the plate inside. You cannot do anything with that pitch besides pull it foul. That's all you can do with it. Now, if he gets it over the plate a little bit more, he'll have a chance to straighten it out. But that location, not a whole lot you can do with it. Good pitch.
Playable.
Fastball in, curveball away.
Max Howerton making the catch there at first base. That was a good job by Parnell.
Good mix right there.
Yeah.
Now, Jake Taylor.
He was in Major League.
He's playing right field now.
He's a catcher.
Get right to Max. Easy out. That's going to end the third, down 6-0. We'll take a
five
break.
Runs, three
back
hits,
more
no
Grizzly
errors.
Baseball.
Runners left on base. Going to the bottom of the.
Sawyer's is about more than sunrooms, patios, and home improvement. For over 30 years, we've been about people, about our community, about you. We make quality products affordable so you can focus on making memories with those who matter most. We bring our passion for great craftsmanship and take pride in the work we do, so you can count on it lasting a lifetime. Give us a call today and see the difference we can make for you.
You're in business to do business, not paperwork. That's where the skills of Potts & Company Certified Public Accountants can help you succeed. Trust the experienced professionals of Potts & Company for tax preparation, bookkeeping, and other business services. Using QuickBooks for your operations? They're QuickBooks experts. The Potts & Company team can help you establish, organize, and optimize your QuickBooks for utmost effectiveness. Visit PottsCPA.com to learn more.
Between life, work, and family, sometimes the person that you need to take care of the most is you.
At Fort Smith Therapy Health and Wellness, you're never alone. Through our counseling, we can help you regain control of your emotions, mental health, and life. We provide both face-to-face and virtual therapy services. Whether it's for your child, family, or yourself, Fort Smith Therapy is here to help your true self shine through.
Schedule your appointment today with Fort Smith Therapy Health and Wellness.
Maddox King Cannon up for the Bears, the bottom of the third.
Yeah, Maddox trying to use the wheels a little bit, create some holes in the defense, make them make some plays. See if we can get something started, get some momentum in
there. Some of these real speedy guys on base, Maddox is one of them.
Get some base runners, put the pressure on them. That's what they are, girls.
Yeah, you got to find a way to string a few together here because, I mean, down 6-0, can't hit a six-run home run, so you got to get some guys on base. And,
can you not?
Can't do it. I haven't seen anybody do it. Seen a lot of people take swings that they think they're
they
going
think
to.
They think they're
going
to
get.
You know.
A little at a time.
Yeah.
All six right now anyway.
No, you don't. There's plenty of game left if you can get anything going. Good location.
Right there.
Good job. Lead off man on. Here we
Maddox
go.
Get a walk. Ty Anderson still the pitcher. The Mounties.
Luke has kind of been up and down a little bit here recently offensively, so they've kind of moved him down the order. Which is not always a bad thing because now he's in a situation where he's probably going to see more fastballs. And, you know, hopefully he can, you know, get it going a little bit. But that's part of being in the middle of the season, though. Sometimes you have some ups and downs offensively. Hitting comes and goes for everybody, you know.
Luke is a really good athlete, plays football for us, linebacker.
Outstanding.
Did a great job last year.
He's a great kid,
nice
too.
Nice rip to center field, but that'll get sized up by Caleb Champion, who has been a great base runner for the Mounties.
He got a fastball over the plate.
Yep.
Hit it right at the center fielder. That's all you can do. We've hit two balls hard in three innings and haven't got anything out of it, so it's just a matter of doing it consistently.
Andrew takes a strike. Maddox at first. We have one down. Bottom of the third. Pitch a little outside, 1-1.
Andrew's really done a good job of being a table setter for us, you know, this year. And got him at the top of the order right now, so he can run. He can handle the bat a little bit, you know, handle it with the short game, with the bunt game and all that stuff. So he's a guy that we definitely need to continue to keep rolling a little bit.
Side pitch from Anderson, caught him swinging. Two down for the Bears. Mason Kincannon at the plate now.
Yeah, man, number one, Mason Kincannon.
What a nice rip in the gap between center and right. I think his brother might be able to score from there. The speed he has.
Oh, definitely. You hit one in the gap with either one of these guys on the base, they're going to be touching the plate for sure.
Easy there, easy
I don't see him. Then the next two pitches, I don't see him, you know, not making an attempt to be aggressive and try to swipe a bag right here. See if he gets to 3-0, he probably won't go, but if we get to 2-1 right here. Lefties are cheaters, Buzz. Coach Walden. They balk every time they throw to first base. I don't care who they are. Never seen one that didn't. Doesn't get called. You just got to accept it.
High and inside. Three and oh. Strike. Boy, you'd like to have two Ken Cannons on.
Yeah, you could really make some things happen with Alex behind them.
Yeah, Martinez coming up. You could have Ken Cannon at second, one at first, and then get a good rip. Boy, you could get back into the thing. Count is full now.
Good 3-1 swing. Don't get cheated on 3-1. Old saying.
Motion at first,
Oh, yeah, we'll be in motion. Full count, two outs. We'll be going right here. Better watch out getting back door. Oh, goodness.
Oh, strike. That's going to end three. We're down 6-0. One on base. We'll take a break. Come back with us. Start the fourth right after this. Roger, six.
Is about to be unbeatable. Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
Welcome back to Grizzly Field. It is 6-0. We're going to go to Coach Little. He's got Coach Hankins in the dugout. Coach?
Coach, so far, season hadn't quite gone the way we'd like it to. We got some injuries. What do we got to do to get this back on track?
Yeah, we just got to keep competing, you know, and not give up the free base and just keep competing, man. Just play routine baseball and air free and just keep putting the ball in play on offense.
Well, Coach, you know, you got Moody. He's been hurt, and he's, you know, definitely our ace, and he's one of our better sticks, too, and we've been struggling scoring runs. So, you know, where are we going to make that up?
Just over. We got this game and I think nine more or eight more conference games. We got time to make a real run here, and you know, it's better to get hot.
How about number two, Caleb, champion?
Well, best to you, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, back to you, Buzz.
Right. You know, Coach's optimistic about it. He knows that we can still have a good last half of this season, try to get us into the tournament.
Got him. Go ahead. Oh. Take those free outs. You know, the thing that you're going to get with Landon Parnell is you're going to get a guy that's going to pound the zone. He's going to have the guys behind him are going to have to make plays, which is, I mean, that's baseball. It's what you want to happen. So you've got a strike thrower, so you got to be ready to make plays right here.
Let's go.
Caleb Champion is at plate now, has really had a good ball game. Leadoff hitter, he's also their center fielder. He's a guy, you know, you pretty much count on him having a good percentage of getting on base. Then you got some backup hitters, Barriola, who hit the home run, and there's a rip down to right field line. He turned on that one pretty good. It's foul ball. But Barriola comes up and hits the home run. Coach Little is going to check out. Coach, thank you. Appreciate you coming in today. Well, he does such a good job the wireless and all the interviews that he does, basketball and now in baseball. We're having football next year. He and Coach Fallure. We're going to have a lot of cool things starting in football. We're going to have some different camera angles and extra wireless on the field.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, I've had so many people tell me, Buzz, that I mean, there is nobody that does it like we do when it comes to the live stream and what you do with everything and your crew here. And I mean, it's as good as it gets. And I've had so many people compliment it about the quality of the picture and, you know, just what you just said, camera angles and the information and keeping people in tune to the ball game. It's first class.
Frower just makes a nice catch there off the bat of Caleb. Coach, thank you for saying that. You know, we work really hard at it, but we have a good time too. It's fun to do it. We experiment with a lot of things. We try some things that I don't know that other broadcast teams or live stream teams would even try. It's like putting a guy up in the crow's nest here.
Yeah.
It's you got to want it. And it's cold up there. The wind's blowing. He's protecting that camera. But we do enjoy doing it.
Good job. Way to keep it in front, Lucas.
Good pick.
Nice job, Lucas, just blocking it. Then Max making a good catch at first.
Let me brag on him on that play right there. Because I'm going to tell you right now, there was zero intent to get out of the way of that baseball. He's playing with his toes on the grass, and he had his mind made up that he was going to square that up, keep it in front, take it off the chest, take it off the face, whatever it took to keep it in front and get that out. That's a big-time play right there.
Tough kid.
That's just the mentality shows right there.
Now, if you meet him in the halls of Northside or in a restaurant somewhere, he's the most polite kid, well-mannered kid.
Mm-hmm.
Comes from a great family.
Absolutely.
And he's just he's one of the most vicious players on the field. When he turns the lights on, it is time to go.
Yeah, his mentality for, I mean, everything that he does, football and baseball-wise, is represented in that play right there.
Yeah.
I mean, because football-wise, I mean, he's a guy that he's the straw that stirs the drink for us in football on the defensive side. And, you know, I'm on the offensive side, but I see him every day in practice. And, you know, I watch our films too and watch him play. And, you know, I hear our defensive coaches talk about him, the ins and outs of and the X's and O's side of what they're doing defensively. And, you know, Lucas is, I mean, he's our guy now defensively. He's a guy that makes it happen, and he's the communicator. He's the quarterback over there on the defensive side, and outstanding football player and great kid, and just can't say enough good things about him.
Are you serious? That is, if I'm not mistaken, that's the third time that Lloyd's been hit by a pitch today.
Yeah, he's going to have a bruise or two.
When you talk about Lucas Calderero football, and he wears, 44?
Mm-hmm.
And there was a guy that played for OU a few years back, the linebacker that wore 44.
Yeah, that guy was an animal.
Brian Bosworth.
Yeah.
And he was definitely a character. He had not a split personality, but he had a persona on the field. Then he had one off the field. He was an extremely smart guy. There was a lot of things that that he did to psych opposing quarterbacks out, you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks before he played, we start sending him letters telling him what it's going to be like to play him. But off the field, you know, he was a very successful student, smart. I think he lived off campus. Maybe he was married when he was at OU.
I can't remember if he was married or not, but I would think that would be one heck of a lifestyle with him when he was in college.
I met him at Big Red Auto in Norman. He had a cover come out on Sports Illustrated. He was in a Corvette with these big speakers in the back of it. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you remember that cover.
Wearing a white suit.
Buddy. Yeah, that's it.
I remember it. I remember it. I was in junior high at the time.
I remember being at Big Red Auto and standing in the showroom floor, and I see him pull up this Corvette, and I said, I know that guy. And then when he gets out with that mohawk and all those multicolored beads and stuff, and you know, you're not really going to – you need to compliment him. You're not going to say anything negative to him, yeah. for sure. Yeah. Lucas is our number 44, though, and he does a great job athletically, and I know he's a good student too.
Absolutely.
I'll vouch for that. I had him in class last year. Yeah.
Oh, did you?
Yes, sir.
Comes from good stock, like you said. The Caldera family is a great family. Long history in Fort Smith.
Barriola draws a walk. Hit it over the left field fence his last time at bat.
So kind of a critical point right here. You got the bases loaded. You're down six, so you don't want to give up a extra base hit of any kind. So Coach Shebist is going out there to kind of make sure Landon understands the situation. And, you know, we got an opportunity to throw one pitch and get an out right here and, you know, not allow them to add to the lead. So
settle the troops and find a way to get the out.
Yeah, Coach Shebist, is there any relation – to James Shebest, who was
it's his daddy,
wide receiver. Yep. At, really?
Sure is.
Yeah. Well, I did.
He's coaching at UNLV right now. Coach James is. And,
well, he was a heck of a receiver.
Oh, he's one of my all-time favorite Razorbacks when I was a kid. I mean, you talk about a wide receiver that would go get it now.
Yeah, what year did he graduate? You remember?
I'm going to say somewhere around 84, 85, somewhere around there, I think.
But he's not a very big –
No,
kid, but
no,
just,
he wasn't a very big guy. And he's even before JJ, even before we hired him here, everywhere he's been, even when he was at Arkansas with Coach Nutt, he's always done a good job of recruiting Fort Smith and, you know,
just a well hit ball. Off the glove, Mason Kincannon is all he can do to try to get a glove on it.
But yeah, James Shebist, when he was at Arkansas and at Ole Miss with Coach Nutt, and he's always really done a good job of keeping in touch with us and, you know, as far as trying to see if we got kids that they want. And he's a great guy, you know, does a great job.
Well, Coach Hankins, we're going to have a meeting at the mound. We're going to take a quick break. Stay with us. We'll be back. More Grizzly baseball right after this.
REP is your trusted source when it's time for you to sell your business or if you are looking to acquire one. We offer a variety of services that help prepare your business for sale. And we also counsel and advise you every step of the way. We take pride in our experience, market knowledge, and integrity. You can be assured your business is in the right hands. Resolution Equity Partners, partnering with you now, preparing for the future.
consumer notice. Interest rates are at a 22-year high. To gauge the demand for lower rates, or Chevrolet of Fort Smith is holding a great percent event. 1.9% financing for 60 months on select models is in effect. New 2023 Silverado 1500, new 2023 Equinox, new 2023 Trailblazers. 1.9% financing. Plus, get over $3,000 in or extra value. Or Chevrolet of Fort Smith.
All right, we're going to have a pitcher change. It's going to be Damarian Newton on the mound.
Always like pitching here in the evenings because of the shadow. You throw a good breaking ball right now, the way this shadow sits on the field.
Yeah.
And the ball coming from sunlight to dark. If you had the right spin on it, it worked to your advantage a little bit. Shadows and lights.
Yeah, we've got that camera in the Crow's Nest that's in center field, but he's looking right back directly into the sun.
Mm-hmm.
And once the sun goes down, and your views get so much better from that angle.
Yeah.
Night games here are fantastic as far as a broadcast goes.
Yeah.
A little bit tougher when you start at 5 o'clock.
Yeah. Tell you what's tough, and it's going down right now, but – this side of the infield, the left side of the infield, earlier, like in early March, late February, that sun's usually going down right here around the press box, and it's shining right this way, and it makes it tough if you catch it at the right time.
Yeah.
Just like Lucas getting that ball hit back at him. I mean.
How bad is for Rogers? Number 18, Andy.
Those sunglasses are worth their weight in gold, I promise you.
Well, Blankenship's going to go to first. That'll load them up. Two down. That's a hit again to the plate.
Coach Walden, I think the tough thing about it is when you know, you give them free passes, it's hard to get over that. But when you can handle it a lot better if they're banging it all over the park.
Right, for sure.
No, he called him out.
We'll take it.
Yeah, the Rogers fans that are here sure didn't agree with that.
No, they didn't.
That'll end the inning. 8-0 is the score. We'll come back. For the bottom of the fourth, stay with us.
Going here, three runners left on base. Going to the bottom of the fourth inning. Rogers,
you out.
At Hug Chevrolet Buick GMC, we dial 782-8940.
This is Joe Calderera with Taliano's Restaurant. We call 782-8940.
Keep warm this winter with a York high-efficiency furnace. Or for more information on endless hot water and a high-efficiency tankless water heater, give Blaylock Heat and Air and Plumbing Services a call at 782-8940.
That's 782-8940.
Welcome back to Hunts Park. It is 8-0. We're at the bottom of the fourth now. Coach Walden has got to leave us. We appreciate her sitting with us here on the broadcast. Now McLean Moody is going to take a seat. We'll be able to talk with him a little bit. McLean, who has been really missed here. He's fighting an injury right now, and we'll talk to him a little bit about when and if he can get cleared, and we will go from there. McLean, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
You're all good. All right, that's McLean Moody, quarterback for the Grizzly football team. Pitcher, a feared pitcher for the Grizzlies. McLean's having to sit it out right now, and I know it's tough for you to be watching. I know you'd like to be in there throwing strikes and heaters and everything else. How you feeling?
I'm feeling better every day. I mean, it's a gradual process.
Yeah.
But 21, Alex Martinez. I mean,
you just got to – there's really not much I can do as in, like, treatment-wise with the injury that I have. So I'm just having to sit back and rest for these set weeks that I've been given. And then I get a follow-up and see what they want to do from there. But, I mean, like I said, there's really not much for me to do on the treatment.
Yeah.
I just sit around and – let it heal on its own.
That's got to be tough for you.
It is.
You'd like to speed the process up. If there was something you could do, you'd be doing it.
It is tough because the whole reason I have the injury is from overworking my body, just doing too much, just going 100 miles an hour every single day, not really resting. And so this rest has been tough because I do like to continue to go.
Well, so, you know, once you get to the end of football – then what's your schedule like before you start baseball?
Really, that's the time whenever I go the absolute hardest, because you would think that's when I would rest, but baseball being the sport that I'm committed to, it is the sport that I do focus on a lot. And so whenever we do get out of football and I'm getting ready and getting geared up for baseball, that's also kind of my off season for summer baseball as well, which is very important to me. And so I do as much as I can to get my body mobile and versatile for pitching, because the pitching mechanics can be a lot more tasking on the body than the football throw. So I just try to get my body ready for any movement that could happen that my body can be in.
Martinez hits a shot to the second baseman, and that'll be the first out. Well, for those of you that are watching the broadcast, I'm sure that you know who McLean Moody is. If you don't, he's 6'6". Runs about what a at some point by your senior year, you'll be a 4.3 guy. He's running in the 4.4s right now.
Yes, sir.
I don't know what your vertical is, but I'm sure it's off the charts too. You throw a 92 mile an hour fastball, you're basically a freak. I mean that in a good way. All right, in a good way.
I appreciate that, Buzz.
You are fun to watch do what you do.
Thank you.
I got such a kick out of watching you throw some of the passes you threw during football season. You had some pretty good receivers, and y'all worked well together. But seeing you get out of some jams and throwing it across the field off your back foot, it was pretty amazing.
There's not much you can do to compare to a Friday night out there. I mean, it's so much fun. It's ecstatic. I mean, just the lights, the atmosphere, the speed of the game. I mean, every play is anywhere from 2 seconds to 5 seconds at max.
Yeah.
I mean, 5 seconds is a long play. So, I mean, it's happening fast, and I like that. It's got to be so quick.
Well, you got your offensive coordinator sitting right next to you. So, I'm sure that you guys.
Number nine, good? Elijah. You're
still here? Okay.
Yes, sir.
I think I had Coach Frazier's muted. Can you hear all right?
I can hear.
Okay, good.
At the moment. No, we get to spend a lot of time together, so it's good. And
oh yeah,
there's always something that, you know, we're trying to work on, and like right now, and you know, with him being shut down and not being able to throw, we're watching film and we're talking about X's and O's, and you know, just trying to keep him in tune with some of the adjustments and shakeups that we're doing offensively, and you know, he's doing a really good job of, you know, soaking it all in, so to speak. So.
Yeah, kind of going at the mental aspect of the whole situation right now, trying to attack that the best we can to get me in the best possible situation whenever I'm physically back.
So tell a lot of people may not know, McLean. Tell everybody what your injury is.
My injury? Yeah. So I have a fractured L3 and L5, which is in the lumbar region of your back. And it's a stress fracture. So basically, like I said earlier, just a stress fracture is doing so much and not really letting your body rest as much as you've been working. So with inadequate rest, your body deteriorates, and over time mine's just gotten worse and worse, and then hence stress fracture. So that's where we're sitting. It's not that bad, though. I mean, I sit out for 4 weeks, get a follow-up, then do a little bit of physical therapy, and then I'll be all right.
Patience.
Yep.
That's really what you're dealing with right now. This is Evan Ross at the plate. Elijah Fieri hit a shot between second and first.
You know, there's opportunity. We've had opportunities in three out of the four innings so far to get something going and score some runs and, you know, kind of stay in it and close the gap a little bit. And you just need a couple good things to happen consecutively to a couple good swings or, you know, steal a bag here and there, get some runners in scoring position, make some contact, and we just hadn't put it together back-to-back yet.
Well, that's going to be the end of the fourth. So we'll take a quick break, come back with the top of the fifth. Stay with us.
With an older car, there's so much maintenance. Knowing that my brakes are covered for life with the Golden Guarantee is a relief. I'd like to be driving this car forever, so that's why I keep taking it back to Midas.
At Escape Camper Vans, we exist to make the outdoors more accessible. We have about 630 vans in our fleet. These vehicles get so much wear and tear. Knowing that there's a warranty on parts through Midas, the Golden Guarantee is so important to our business.
Whether it's record temperatures or below freezing, Ted's is here to keep you comfortable all year long. We've been in business for over 55 years, and we love serving our community. Call today and schedule your seasonal checkup so you're always prepared for what's around the corner. Ted's Air Conditioning and Heating, always ready to help. Tell us you saw Duke and save 10%.
That was kind of the situation with my back whenever I was trying to pitch with it. I was good, and
all right, welcome back to Grizzly Field. Guys, we're down 8-0. Need to get three outs here, then try to start putting something together.
Oh, we got Maddox in now.
So Maddox Ken Cannon will be the pitcher. So who are they? Trying to see who's going to be at short.
Top of the fifth inning, batting for Rogers.
Evan Ross.
Yeah.
This kid hitting, isn't he the one that pitched yesterday?
I don't know if he threw yesterday or not.
That's what they were saying in the dugout. I wasn't quite sure on how he did because they don't want me riding the bus to the trips, so I wasn't 100% sure how he pitched yesterday.
Jake Taylor, he's actually been in right field.
He did throw last night. This on the notes that I've got from Coach Melson. Had two hits last night, and they're trying to get, you know, obviously a good left-handed stick. Just trying to get him going a little bit, get him in a rhythm, get him in a groove.
Dylan and I had talked earlier about getting and I know McLean would love this. You see some of the broadcast in college and in the pros where as soon as the pitch is made, the speed comes up. Well, we're trying to get that it's compatible with our software.
Right.
It's available, but it's extremely expensive. Hmm.
I can only imagine.
Come make a play. Attaboy, Andrew. It's not Andrew, is it? Who is that?
That was Andrew.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yep. Andrew can cover some good ground out there. I've noticed that.
He really can.
He's an all-around good baseball player.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Man, yeah.
I mean, anytime you have a kid starting pitcher lead off, I mean, he's probably a pretty good player.
It's McIntosh at the plate. McIntosh plays left field.
Alex is fighting through it right now, isn't he? You just see his body language wincing on some pitches when he's receiving it back here. Life of a catcher. Just because they wear all that gear doesn't mean that they don't break down. Good pitch.
Outside edge.
Yeah. Good location right there. That ball's not getting hit hard very often.
You know, having one of those speed guns and having it come up on your broadcast is cool. It's not the most important thing, but it's like the ace in tennis or the hole-in-one or the big drive in golf. Yeah, that's what everybody's interested in. Well, how fast does he throw?
That's true. I could name time and time again. I've been on watching college baseball games, and if they don't have it, I'm a little bummed because I like to see
what they're throwing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Back to the top of the order right here.
Champion just a little bit late on that one, right into his own dugout.
Yeah, he's a good player, and I mentioned earlier he signed with Southeast Missouri, who is a Division I school, got a good baseball program. They'll compete for regionals, you know, on their better years. And
might have got him.
Oh, there's a collision there, and that is painful.
Sound like they hit heads.
Oh. That's Evan Ross playing shortstop.
With these headphones on, I could hear the thump.
Yeah.
When they ran into each other.
Yeah, that was solid. Coach Hankins out there checking on him, and sure hope that he's all right. He's upright now.
That's always, you know, middle infielders covering bags, first baseman balls thrown up the line, catchers plays at the plate. Those are always the toughest collisions, situations like that, because they're making plays on the baseballs and they don't get a chance to brace themselves.
Right.
You know, when you can brace yourself for impact, you got a chance to maybe get through it a little bit, and, you know, maybe it's not going to hurt quite as bad. You know, the injury won't be quite as severe, but when you're making a play on the ball and you're pretty much completely limp and you get drilled like that, it's tough.
It is tough.
It's dangerous.
Cash Standards will come in for Evan Ross, and it's good to see him get off under his own power. You know, you're always afraid of a knee injury or a head injury or something, but to see him walk off under his own power is always good. And the parents, they definitely hold their breath.
Yeah, I don't care who you are. You do. You hold your breath. You do. You just. Who's that? Is that Cash?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're talking about SEMO, Southeast Missouri. Mm-hmm. It's a good program.
They are. They're a good program. Good mid-major program. And, you know, they're in there with the UCAs and the UALRs and Arkansas States of the world. You know, they're always in the mix, it seems like, in recent years. They're I don't know who the head coach there is, but I just know that, you know, if you watch college baseball, they're usually hear about them, you know.
When I was playing football at Tech, we played against them. Played them there my freshman year. And I had the strangest thing happen. After the game was over, I had one of the cheerleaders ask me if I could ride back with in their van. I said, hey, no, wait a minute. Let me run and ask coach. I went to ask head coach, and he's told me to get my you-know-what on the bus. I had a
yeah. I could have told you where that conversation was going to go real quick.
But you know, when you're 19 years old, you at least ask.
Oh yeah,
coach, can I?
That's funny.
Yeah, make them tell you no.
Yeah,
right.
I actually had a decent game then, but I think if I'd have had a bad game, you probably said, "Yeah, why don't you?" Right back with the cheerleaders.
Yeah. Talking about Southeast Missouri right now, they're one game under 500 this year. And I'm looking at some of the teams that they played. I mean, they played Dallas Baptist, who's in a super regional every year. They beat Missouri, an SEC team.
Wow.
This is Watson.
Man, I feel like this has been
back. McClay, we've seen a lot of
hit by pitches.
A lot of Rodgers players hit by pitches.
That's what I was just about to say. I feel like this is the most hit by pitches I think I've seen in a while in a singular game.
Well, Zach Lawling has. Well, here, this is him. He's been hit three times.
Yeah.
I'd be a little bit gun shy.
That's three times just today?
Today.
Wow. That's all three at bats. Huh.
Be a good time for a double play ball and get yourself out of the inning right here.
That was a good one.
Nip and tuck. Nip and tuck.
Yeah, I thought that caught the outside edge.
I've pitched on that mound out there around this time, and I know what he's feeling right there. That sun can get brutal to the pitcher.
Yeah, how much does that affect you?
It can seriously be tough. Like seeing the target and picking up your signs, it can take a second.
Well, Lawling's gonna take a base and that'll score a run. Like he just thankfully didn't get hit again.
Yeah. Take base runners any way you can, no question. As a hitter, you're glad to get on base any way you can, but at the same time, if you do have an 8 or 9 run lead, you really kind of want to stand in there and hit when you've been hit by a pitch three times, but, you know, that's part of it. The biggest thing you sit here and watch the way this game's unfolded is, you know, obviously not throwing enough strikes to get to a 9-run deficit. But runners on base, and all of a sudden, boom, they hit a, they get a base hit or hit a double, or they hit the three-run home run a while ago. Anytime you're posting crooked numbers, and they've got two innings so far where they've, you know, seven runs in two innings of a 9-0 lead, kind of tells the tale.
Well, walk scores another run. 10-0.
That's the thing about walks. I mean, those hits will kill you because you get those walks. You walk two, three batters in a row, you got your defense sitting back, kind of getting lackadaisical, and then the hit happens and everybody's kind of caught by surprise.
Off guard.
Yep. So it can – there's different aspects to those strikes and balls that people don't really see that can have an effect on the game.
Looks like Lucas Caldera is going to be our pitcher.
I know Coach Shebus, the pitch, you know, he's your pitching coach, and I know he's a worker. He's, you know, does a good job, and young guy that relates to you guys well, and I know he's working hard, and it's just a matter of putting it all together. And it, you know, here's the thing about pitching. You've got complete control over everything that happens till the ball leaves your hand. So it's just a matter of being able to repeat the delivery, you know, and throw to the mitt and play catch. And, you know, when you're not as comfortable or you're not throwing as well on the mound, as McLean can tell you, it can be pretty brutal from that rubber to that home plate, 60 feet, 6 inches, if you're not comfortable with what you're doing mechanically.
Oh, yeah, it can. And seems so easy to sit up there and throw strikes, but, I mean, at times it can be the hardest thing to do. I mean, you can say just slow it down and get it in there, but, I mean, if you're not comfortable, like you're saying, it can be extremely difficult.
Well, McClay, what happens in a situation like that where you're not feeling comfortable? Does it take a strikeout or a great play by, you know, one of your fielders? What does it for you, you know, to get you back in your comfort zone?
For me, well, my brother, he taught me. He's in college. One of his college coaches told him that it is scientifically proven that if you just zone out, take a deep belly breath, and as you're exhaling that breath, lock in on where you need to deliver the pitch, there, it's 9 out of 10 times it's going there. So for me, I just take that big belly breath, lock in on the catcher's mitt, and deliver the pitch. And that feel that you get out of that pitch that's in the zone and what you are on your normal day, it can translate to the next one and then to the next one and so on, and then now you're in the groove.
So do you have a go-to pitch?
My fastball.
Fastball, that's what you're gonna lead on.
And honestly, if it's a day that my fastball is not on, I'll flip a curveball in there until I get the feel for that, and then I know I have the feel for the fastball. Because, I mean, if you can flip your off speed and get a feel for that, then you typically find your feel for your fastball.
Batting for Rogers, number 19, Bo Williams.
That's how you want to start.
I'm going to put McLean on the spot right here, Buzz. I bet he's going to get it right, though. McLean, what's the best pitch in baseball?
First pitch strike.
There you go. He got it.
You could say the third, but, I mean, you can't have the third without the first one.
Or just a strike in general.
Yep.
That's right. Coach Breedlove, years ago, my baseball coach and the first baseball coach, the legendary Coach Breedlove, first baseball coach at Northside High School years ago, I remember him asking me, he said, how do you hold a strike? I didn't know what to say. I couldn't answer a question. I could not answer the question. He said, Chad Frazier, how do you hold a strike? And I just looked at him, didn't say a word. I couldn't talk. I still don't know the answer to that question.
Did you
and I'm 50 years old.
Did you ever ask him? What is the answer?
No, I never did. I don't know if he had the answer either, but he put me on the spot, that's for sure.
You know, he was a good football player, too.
Absolutely.
I'm not going to tell you where he played.
The place where legends are made?
Really?
Well, Arkansas Tech.
That's right.
That's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Arkansas
right.
Tech. Oh, I'm not going
say,
there.
I wouldn't go say high school.
No. Right. I'm not going there. No.
Yeah, there's been some good players come out of Tech.
Coach Breedlove is my guy. There is no doubt. I don't know where I'd be without him. High school. Continued to work with me through college when I needed it. I mean, just been really lucky with the coaches that I've had, and he's one of the ones at the top of the list, no doubt.
Maddox Kincannon squeezed that one.
That was a pretty good play.
Yeah. Out of his shortstop position.
He was probably ready for me to go by the time I got out of high school because he coached me in football. He was it's kind of like McLean right now. Now, I'm not out here in baseball, but Coach Breedlove was the quarterback coach, and he was the head baseball coach. So I was with him every day.
That's kind of like it's kind of like Max Frazier.
Yeah.
I'm with him every single day. It feels
every
like
day.
He's That's with right. me in football. He comes out here to baseball. It's the exact same situation.
Attaboy. Way to get out of it. Need to get it going offensively right here and extend this game a little bit.
Well, Ken Cannon short and second. Get us out of that. 11-0. Bottom of the fifth.
We need to hang some right here.
Guys, we'll take a break. Stay with us. We'll be back right after this.
Sawyer's is about more than sunrooms, patios, and home improvement. For over 30 years, we've been about people, about our community, about you. We make quality products affordable so you can focus on making memories with those who matter most. We bring our passion for great craftsmanship and take pride in the work we do so you can count on it lasting a lifetime. Give us a call today and see the difference we can make for you.
You're in business to do business, not paperwork. That's where the skills of Potts & Company Certified Public Accountants can help you succeed. Trust the experienced professionals of Potts & Company for tax preparation, bookkeeping, and other business services. Using QuickBooks for your operations? They're QuickBooks experts. The Potts & Company team can help you establish, organize, and optimize your QuickBooks for utmost effectiveness. Visit PottsCPA.com to learn more.
Between life, work, and family, sometimes the person that you need to take care of the most is you.
At Fort Smith Therapy Health and Wellness, you're never alone. Through our counseling, we can help you regain control of your emotions, mental health, and life. We provide both face-to-face and virtual therapy services. Whether it's for your child, family, or yourself, Fort Smith Therapy is here to help your true self shine through.
Schedule your appointment today with Fort Smith Therapy Health and Wellness.
All right, welcome back. Jackson Stevens at the plate. We are down 11-0 in the bottom of the fifth, so we've got to get a couple runs on the board to continue on. One and two to Jackson. Like that pitch, just a little bit late on it. And I meant to talk to Coach Walden about potential fundraiser. We were going to do it a few years back when Kaylin Massey was the pitcher. I was going to see if I could get a hit off of her and try to raise money for, you know, bet on whether I could get a hit or whether I could donate money and have it, you know, whatever cause to go to, but I was pretty convinced by other people you can't hit her. So that kind of
I would have put in some money
against me?
You think you'd have barreled it up good enough that that might have been an issue?
Do what?
You think you'd have barreled it up good enough that that might have been an issue if you hit it back at her?
It, what would have been an issue?
If you hit it back at her.
Oh. Coach, I watched her pitch, and, I mean, she had some velocity. I think she threw it pretty close to 60.
Oh, wow.
And, she can throw it.
And it was a lot of movement on it. Mm-hmm. And you're pretty close. You know, it's a little bit different.
Oh, yeah. Number four. 48 feet.
Yeah, it's like it's there quick. And so anyway, I never did it. But I think we ought to try to do it again. Mallory will be tough to hit, too, just because she has so much stuff.
I think I'm going to have to be there. I think I'm going to have to be there to see that.
Well, I'll talk to Coach Walden about it and see if we can raise some money and maybe a good cause for it.
I'll heckle you from outside the fence. How about that? But I'll be there.
I get three swings, you know. It's not a one and done. One down, Maddox. Get a little meat on the ball here.
Give a little shout out to my dad and Harold Raines, who are no longer with us, but Harold was my dad's best friend. His son Ryan's like a brother to me. And back in the day when they were playing fast pitch softball, you know, back in the 70s and 80s in Fort Smith when it was really big.
Yeah.
And it's in the wintertime, and Harold could absolutely, I mean, he threw gas, and it was all over the place. I mean, all over the place. And a guy another good friend of my dad's, and Harold's, a guy named Rick Hunley, who lives here in Fort Smith, is just, you know, I've known him my whole life. And it was in the wintertime, and they went to the park, and they were practicing, and Harold was throwing. Yeah, Rick comes up to hit. I remember them telling me this story, and Harold let one go, and it just a riser, and it hit Rick right in the head.
Oh.
Like, I mean, knocked him out, like colder than the wedge. And, you know, of course, he's probably a little upset. And they said, Harold looked at him and said, get up, I'm going to hit you again.
Is that what made Rick start playing golf?
Yeah.
Rick was one heck of a golfer.
That's what I heard.
Yeah.
That's funny. Nah, those that men's fast pitch softball, difficult.
They can move it.
It looks difficult.
It is a defensive game.
Yeah.
Not a lot of runs get scored.
No. Runs are a premium.
Spinner.
Ty Anderson, pitcher, makes the play. That's going to do it for today's game. Ty Anderson went the entire five innings, did a great job for the Mounties.
Well, I got to go shake him up.
Well, we really enjoyed McLean Moody being here with us. Good luck.
Yes, sir. Heal up. Thank y'all. Heal yes, sir. Up. That is the goal.
All right. McLean Moody. All right, we're going to take a real quick break. We'll be back right after this. Welcome back to Hunts Park. Didn't end like we wanted it to, 11-0. Started out a little bit shaky. Coach, we had the bases loaded, no outs. Able to work our way out of it with a double play. And had that happen again to us in the second inning. But then it just started kind of coming apart a little bit. And just really never could get the bat on the ball, couldn't get the base runners we needed. Defensively, I felt like we did okay for a while.
Yeah, we hung in there a little bit defensively. I think the thing, you know, you go back and look at this, I'd love to see the scorebook or see the stat line, the box score on this game. But, I mean, you know, bottom line is, you know, got to throw strikes and got to play behind them. But, you know, you put a lot of pressure on yourself when you don't score. And, you know, we couldn't get it going offensively today. The left-hander for Rodgers threw a good ball game, and then one thing he did was he sat there and pounded the zone all day.
Threw strikes,
and I, you know, that's not being critical by any means of our guys, because hey, these coaches, they're working, they're trying to figure it out. Kids are trying to figure it out. It's just right now the momentum isn't on our side, and you know, like Coach Hankins said in his interview with Coach Little earlier was, you know, there's still time to get it going and get it fixed and play better baseball. It's just a matter of going out and doing it.
Right.
And, you know, I think this team is very capable. A bunch of good kids, and they're working hard. And I don't think that they have sacked up the lunches yet or sacked up the bats, so to speak, to, you know, and thrown in the towel. I think that they're grinding and they're working. But baseball is a game of confidence and momentum. Yeah. You know,
yeah, I was talking to Coach Hankins yesterday about the season so far, and he said that he was going to have Coach Solly talk to him, and I found out today that he did talk to him, and Coach Solly got him pretty fired up and kind of paralleled it to a couple of really good boxers, and you got to make a choice. You know, you're going to go out there, you're going to throw haymakers, and if you get hit and go down, you got to make a decision on whether you're going to get up or not.
Yeah.
And they're at that point right now. But you have some really good players. You got a great coaching staff. They can do that.
Yeah.
And games they have coming up now, I think we can get some wins. But it's not a want to anymore. It's a have to.
Yeah. And I think you hit it right on the head with, you know, the when Coach Solly talked to him. That's one of the things he talked about was talking about the boxers is. You know, you're going to get hit in the mouth.
Yeah.
You're going to get punched in the mouth, and you're going to get knocked down. It's just a matter of whether or not you can get back up. And you know, we've been punched in the mouth a few times. It's a matter of whether how we're going to respond. And we haven't quite done that yet like we need to get back in ball games and answered when somebody's kind of punched us. But they're working. I mean, I think they're going to continue to get better. And I promise you one thing, with that red and white on and that grizzly across their chest – they're not going to lay it down. I think they're going to keep competing, you know, and however it works out after that, that's how it works out. But, you know, I think within the program, you know, they don't have it in them to just lay it down and quit.
No, so, they've got too good. Their leaders are too good.
That's right. That's exactly right.
So I'm looking forward to a better second half of this season. But I want to say thank you to Coach Walden for sitting in with us, the head coach for the Lady Bears softball team. Coach Little is always doing what he does with the wireless mic and his interviews and all his knowledge. Can't say enough about you, Coach Frazier. And, man, you're a legend for as far as Grizzlies go. And your knowledge and what you bring to the broadcast is awesome. Thank you for taking the time. I know you got a lot of things that you have to do, a lot of things that you're responsible for, but I appreciate your time.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you, Buzz. And I enjoy being a part of it and enjoy all these, you know, I love Northside High School and just like a lot of people in this community and I like supporting these coaches and in every sport as much as possible and appreciate what they all do. You know, we all work together and you being a big part of our athletic program, you know, we all try to work with you as much as we can. And
that's helpful. That's really helpful for us.
Well, we appreciate you and everything that you do and your crew and what you do for us out in the community and for the school and everything. And it's just, you know, it's a special place and a lot of special people. And I'm just glad to be a part of it.
Well, there's nothing like being a Northside Grizzly.
That's right.
No question about it. I was here years ago, and we've got Coach Hankins. Let me go ahead and get a headset on him real quick before we sign off. All right, we got Coach Hankins mic'd up here. Coach, I know it didn't end like you wanted to, but Coach Frazier and I were just talking about what we have coming and what we need to do and the fact that it can be done.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it didn't go how we wanted to, but Never does when you have an inning where you walk seven or eight in a row. And then I think it was in the teens for the game. I mean, just free bases. And I mean, we didn't make them hit it like we didn't make them earn it like we did last night, you know. So, but yeah, you're right. We control our destiny. I mean, we got Bentonville or Southside, Bentonville, Springdale left, and Heritage to close it out. So that's, you know, there's eight possible games left. So,
right.
You know, we kind of control what we can control. So just got to go do it.
Well, Coach, we know that if it can be done, y'all are going to get it done. And we were just talking about the talk that Coach Solly had with the team, and you're going to get hit in the mouth, but you got to get up and go to the next game. And we look forward to that. We got Southside back-to-back Monday and Tuesday. The Grizzly Sports Network will be there for that. And we're going to – good things are going to start happening.
Yeah, you know, just – winning's contagious,
right.
Hitting's contagious, you know, but, you know, like you said, I mean, it's at the beginning of the year, we didn't expect things to be the way it is right now, and kind of shows what kind of player you are. If you're gonna bounce back and, you know, pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and, you know, and get back on it and try to compete, you know, but I think we're very capable. We have We have the ability, we have the talent, we have, you know, we got the pitchers. We just got to string some things together, and guys get hot. And, you know, like I said earlier, you'd rather get hot late than get hot early. So
right. Yeah, that's exactly right. It's the way you got to look at it.
That's right.
Well, Coach, just need
some good things to happen.
Yeah.
You know, baseball is a lot about confidence and momentum. And when things start, you know, rolling your way a little bit, you got an opportunity to get some momentum going and get some good things happening. So that's what it boils down to a lot of times.
Coach, thanks for checking in with us. We appreciate that. Yeah. We'll say thank you to all of our sponsors, our major sponsor, Fort Smith Therapy. If it wasn't for them, you know, we'd have a really tough time doing our broadcast, but it's a group effort. We sure appreciate everybody that chips in. And that's going to wrap it up here from Grizzly Field at Hunts Park. We're going to see you Monday.
Hey, thank y'all. Thank y'all for being here.
Thank you, Coach. We'll see you Monday for the Southside game, then again Tuesday. So hopefully we get some back-to-back wins there. Coach, I'm Buzz Sawyer saying so long. Alongside Chad Frazier. Go Bears.